everyone, this is Billy. Today I've created this controller for my dishwasher. Let me show you how to make it. If you like my video, please click like, subscribe, and send to your friends to watch too. Last time I showed you how to make a breadboard version of the dishwasher controller. Today I'm going to make the ultimate product, put it in a box, put in the power supply, and try run it. I find out that last time I made a mistake. In this circuit diagram, there's a missing wire between 5 volts of the NUC MCU and the PDVCC, which is 5 volts of the relay module. So I find that some of the module cannot run on 3.3 volts. So it's better to just remove the jumper that take on the VCC to be the relay's VCC, and take out that yellow jumper, and then connect a wire from the 5 volts of the NUC MCU to the pin called JD-VCC, which is the 5 volt used by the relay. But you make sure you need to remove the jumper first before you do it. Otherwise, you will short circuit the NUC MCU and it may burn the chip. Be careful. Hi everyone. Today I'm going to continue with the hardware setup of the dishwasher. So in order to avoid leakage of water damaging the electronic components, we need to find this water sealed box. There's a silicon, the white rubber like silicon tube here can seal the water. So after you fasten the screw, there will be no leakage. And then we need to find a circuit board same size that can fit into this box here. And then we can lay out what we want to put in to this circuit board. The first thing we would want to put in this 220 volts to 5 volts power converter, put it all the way to the right. And then we have this 4-way relay module, put it here. So this area will be the AC high voltage area. And then we have the NUC MCU D1 mini, that is our ESP8266. And then we have the I2C OLED SSD1306. Okay, and then we'll try to put this in, see how it fits. Okay, nice. Then we have the button. Button will be on the outside of the box because we need to press it. We will drill some two holes, very small holes, and then pass the wire and stick the button on the outside. Okay, and then we will need to drill a hole here or here, maybe here, and then the cable and interface cable, AC electricity cable, will all pass through this hole. But we need to seal the hole to avoid leakage. Because this relay module is handling high voltage, so we need to use this plastic screws to insulate it further so it won't touch the coppers down here. After that, we can put it in place. So there's a lot of clearance between the board and the high voltage area. Then we can mount it there.
Then we need to mount this one. Right this way. I've soldered this power adapter and using these terminals to connect to the mains electricity. Next, I'm going to put in this module, the relay module, and connect the rest of the circuit. So next, we need to connect from the live, that is the red pin, of the mains electricity supply to the middle of the relay. That means the middle pin. Each relay has three pins. The middle pin is the selector. So we have to daisy chain it and connect to the middle pin. Let me finish the last one. Okay, so it's done. From the red terminal, which is the life of the electricity supply, to the middle pin, and daisy chain it. So that we can put the frame relay module back in place. That's it. Next, we have to solder the output of the power adapter, the negative and the positive 5 volts, to the relay module's ground input here and the positive 5 volt input. So we cannot solder directly to this VCC because VCC is 3.3 volts. Okay, and then we extend a wire, this golden wire, and this blue wire, we extend it to the ground and 5 volt input pin. That is the first pin and the second pin of the ESP8266. Let me plug it in. Okay, you see, first pin is 5 volts, so it's the golden wire that we connect to the VCC. Be careful, the VCC is the pin here, not here. This one is 3.3 volts. We cannot short circuit. So the 5 volt need to connect to this JD VCC pin. Okay, and then the 5 volts will be daisy chained with the 5 volts in the ESP8266, the NUC MCU D1 mini. And the ground wire connect from the power supply, the black wire. We also daisy chain with this blue wire and connect to the second pin, the G, the ground of the NUC MCU. Okay, and then we connect one more wire from the VCC, the first pin on the left here, the VCC. This is the 3.3 volt. We connect that wire to the VCC pin here. VCC pin. Yeah, you can't mix it, otherwise it won't work. Next, we will finish up all the rest of the wiring. Okay, I've completed soldering the wires according to the circuit diagram. So you can refer to that. Basically, just connect the relay's IN1, IN2, IN3, IN4 pins to the relative pins in the ESP8266. And then we have a few jumpers. The first one is the OLED. The OLED jumper socket for connecting the OLED SSD1306. Okay. So we need to solder the 4 pins there, VCC, ground, SCL, and SDA. and just connect them to the right pin in the ESP8266. And then we also have this temperature sensor. We need to have a long wire and then connect to this socket, and we can then plug into this connector. Like this. Okay, so the first connector is for the temperature sensor. And then the second connector is for the water level sensor. So we have four pins, but only the first three will be used because we're running out of pins in the ESP8266. So just plug in here. Okay. And then the last jumper is for this button. For this button, we need to first drill two holes in the cover before we can solder the jumper. Okay, so let me cover it. I want the button to be just below the menu. So let's drill the first hole. Okay. And then the second hole should be close. Like this. Then later on, we'll use the hot glue gun to seal the button. Okay, so we have connected the mains power over here in this wiring block. And now we can plug in the sensors, plug in the temperature sensor, and then plug in the water level sensor, and finally the button. Okay, and we can try to power on and see what happened. Okay, we've connected everything. Let's power up and see what happened. Okay. Let's see. Let's do a test. You can see the relay module LED is blinking. And the temperature sensor here. Let me hold it and see whether the temperature rise. Okay, rising. Okay, and the water level sensor is empty. Okay, take out one, take out two. Okay, seems to be functioning normal.